In spring of 2003, they recorded their second album, Open to Interpretation, at Simon Stribling's Holy Mackerel Studio in Burnaby. They worked on their showmanship skills and repertoire, and soon had a book of original arrangements featuring vocal harmonies by the front line, with personality to boot. At the Chilliwack Festival that year, the band was approached by the director of the Sun Valley Jazz Jamboree, Tom Hazard, who invited them to his festival that October. They were a hit and have been performing there every year since. That fall, they said goodbye to well-liked sousaphonist Brock Rutley as he went to travel abroad. April 2004 brought the biggest change in personnel in a few years. A fiery, hard-swinging bass player named Georgia Corba from Capilano College. Within a month, she had played her first gig with the band, recorded an album, Eight to the Bar, and performed at her first festival. History was made at the Chilliwack Festival when the band befriended a particularly young and energetic dancing couple who shone even on the fastest tempos, Joel Schwarz and Louise Kurt. Joel and Louise were a particularly proactive part of a large network of dancers in Vancouver, and the groundwork for a lasting friendship was formed. On November 13, 2004, Vancouver swing history was made again as the 51st Eight played for over 200 young dancers as part of an event Joel and Louise had organized.
That show was amazing. It totally floored us because the energy was incredible. At one point, this guy from Seattle, Kevin Buster, he was sitting in playing saxophone, and he proceeded to crowd surf off the stage like it was a rock show. We got encored, and we could only think, who are these crazy people? And we knew we were friends.
Since then, the band has performed for hundreds of young dancers in BC, Washington, Oregon, California, and Idaho. Around that same time, Josh Roberts exposed his talent as a graphic artist as he designed the website and artwork for the CD, all while graduating from CSS. The whole band had entered the real world. In the spring of 2005, the 51st Eight recorded and released their fourth album, Worth the Wait, a more swing-oriented offering which gained a little radio airplay in the Vancouver area. Unable to make the jump to pro band status and working too much to take the time off, they declined being a youth band at the Sacramento Jubilee and concentrated instead on interest from other festivals.
The biggest hurdles for us at that time, besides being in our awkward late teenager stage, were breaking out of youth band status and developing an expanding repertoire. Fortunately, our local societies like the Chilliwack Jazz Society, the Vancouver Dixieland Jazz Society, and the White Rock Traditional Jazz Society fed us local gigs.
They were well received at the Redwood Coast Music Festival and were added to the 2006 rosters for Seaside, Port Angeles, and Sisters, Oregon. They recorded Live at the Hot Jazz to help benefit one of the last remaining hot jazz clubs in Vancouver. Lucas Matheson was the first to wed, marrying his beautiful wife Danica in December of 2005. By 2006, the band had matured exponentially, both musically and personally. With 5 years' experience of playing together and 7 music majors, there was no end to what they could do creatively. Audiences across the board seemed to notice, as venues were packed at festivals up and down the West Coast. That spring, Bria graduated from Capilano College with her degree in jazz performance, and longtime drummer Jeremy Roberts got married in the summer to his lovely wife, Chantel. That fall, they released their 6th and best album yet, Life's a Beach, and Georgia graduated with a bachelor's in music. In 2007, they continued to play an average of 1 festival a month, plus other gigs. Vashti became the 3rd happily married member as Mrs. Dave Fairbairn and began directing musicals in the Greater Vancouver area. Evan was winning national awards as one of Canada's up-and-coming jazz artists. Bria had started touring more frequently as a guest artist on the East Coast, Europe, and Asia, as well as with her other co-led group, Mighty Aphrodite. Georgia, also of MAJB, and Josh were picked up in 2006 by Simon Stribling for a hard-driving, 5-piece band called the New Orleans Ale Stars. Colin graduated with a bachelor's degree in music education from Trinity Western University. The last change in personnel came when Kentucky-born Benji Bohannon replaced Jeremy as the full-time drummer for the band, bringing a wonderful energy and southern swing. 10 years after its start at Chilliwack Senior Secondary School, the 51st Eight Jazz Band is going stronger than ever and is no longer considered a rarity in their area. Ever since 1998, Chilliwack has been producing young Dixieland jazz players as frequently as their crops of corn. The 51st 8 has been instrumental in nurturing the younger generations by providing clinics, sponsorship, private lessons, and mentoring at band camp. The third generation of the band, the Dixie Nine, are now a group of young college musicians making the jump to pro band status and mentoring the next crop. The newest group at Chilliwack Senior, the Back Alley Strutters, will be making their first trip to the Sacramento Jubilee this year. Also this year, the Vancouver Dixieland Jazz Society is proud to be sponsoring 10 CSS students to attend the Heebie Jeebies Band Camp in Port Angeles, Washington.
Something wasn't right, but then you came along and helped me sing a song, and now I feel okay. I hope it can stay this way. You know we got a good thing going, and I don't wanna see it end. You know we got a good thing going, and I don't wanna see it end. Are these the good days that I've heard so much? There goes the heartbreak that I can live without. Uh-huh. I've been so frustrated, bitter, mean, jaded. I've taken for granted all the things I've got. But now that you are here, this